Hello, today I'd like to make roll out cookies, which is in a part one. We make a whole bunch of cookies dough, and in the different parts we will decorate into different characters. We can incorporate it in a part one Spider-Man, and we can make some flowers for Mother's Day in another part, and we can make also the Lego Movie heroes, basically characters, and we can make basically all sorts of stuff. So what we do is, first in the part one we will make actual cookie dough, and we will decorate it as the Spider-Man, Batman masks, and the Captain America shield. So what we do is, now I did use already once this cookie recipe, because this is excellent for roll out cookies, as well as you can use already pre-mixed sugar cookie mix, which is you can purchase from a supermarket, or you can use my recipe, which is being tested and it works very well. So what we do is, here we have one cup of unsalted butter, which is softened, and it's one and a half cups of just a normal sugar. What we do is, here we beat together sugar and butter with electric mixer until it's nice, light and fluffy. Then we can add one egg, half a cup of almond essence, and one and a half teaspoon of vanilla essence. I did not have clear, but I don't think it will make any difference. Let's beat our mixture first. Once our butter change color, become lighter, what we do is we add one egg, half a teaspoon of almond essence, one and a half teaspoon of vanilla, and we beat all that together. Once you incorporate it in the egg, what we do in the vanilla essence with the almond essence, what we do is, here we have 2 3/4 cups of plain flour, which is mixed with 1 teaspoon of baking powder and 1 teaspoon of salt. So that's what we have in our flour mixture. What we do is, next we add 1 cup at a time and on slow mixing, just to incorporate it. If mixture become a little bit too stiff, just take a spoon and start mixing with the spoon. Adding 1 cup at a time and mixing after each addition. Once dough ready, what you do, bring up a little bit in inside your bowl into one nice cookie dough bowl. As you can see, it's quite smooth. And what we do is, next, once we prepare our cookie dough, which is make this the basic recipe for this cookie dough, will make about 3 dozens of the 3-inch cookies. So they're good size cookies, and 3 dozens, it's a good portion. So, but this is just for this particular amount ingredients in the recipe. If you want making even more, of course you can double, but 3 dozen, it's a good size. So what we do is, here we just place this dough here, and what we do is we're making first part one, which is will be decorating Spider-Man, Batman, and Captain America shield. So I just was another day in the party shop, and I saw this mask, which is you can get in the party shop, or a lot of even cheap shop has it. See, you can actually purchase one of those, Or you can print image from the internet and actually cut it out. Because what we will making, we will make a mask and we put a popsicle stick inside like this. And this us, for us will be our actually Spider-Man mask. Now, for Batman, well, I draw myself basically. I just look and make sure you're able to see it. So I draw good size of a Batman headpiece. So what we will do here, we cut it out and cut eyes out as well. So principle will be same. We will put a popsicle stick inside this for Batman. Now, for the Captain America, I just take from my head basically, but what we will do is we will use different size. This is biggest, 98 millimeters, which is 3 7/8 of inch. It's the biggest one. And we take different size of cookie cutters and create basically nice size Captain America shield, which is little tiny star we will place in the middle basically of the cookie. So what we do is let's cut it out and roll some the I'll not be make it all of from this dough. We just divide it into different parts. So I just take in part and make one of each. So simply take basically if you're making just a Spider-Man or just this recipe, you can roll out whole dough. And what we do is we just place it our Spider-Man mask. And what we do is we just go right around and cut it out with a sharp, nice knife all around. Something we will do for the Batman headpiece as well. What we do is here we will cut out eyes as well because we wanted to make as a real Spider-Man mask. Of course, you can make it bigger or smaller because it does not really make it, or you're making sort of fun type stuff, or you just wanted to make it real size of mask. It does not really matter. What you do is here make slightly larger eyes. I tell you why, because dough usually is does have tendency to the rise a little bit, and we don't want completely our eyes be closed up because of the dough rising. So what we do is carefully with a knife work it and place it on top of the baking tin, which is with grease, and line with a baking paper. Why I grease it? It's actually no need to really sometimes, but I just thinking I might be do by hand actually, which is better. But you can use something like spatula as well. So what we do is here, basically, reason is I grease it because it's easier to actually stick sometimes baking paper actually to the baking tin. So once we're happy what we achieve here, what we do is next we simply use one on lollipop sticks, get thick ones. This is Wilton. It's actually made from pressed sort of kind of, it's not a plastic basically, pressed sort of wood. So what we do, probably use popsicle, and what we do is we carefully on the middle just oh sorry, I just twist myself here, we are just on the middle nicely insert it in. I would say probably half of whatever cookie size you have, that would be good one to make sure it's secure. And here we are, one is done. So what we do is with next one, let's roll out this cookie dough, and we do next one is a Batman, which is we just cut it out. For the Batman, we just roll out our cookie dough and use your cut out template and cut it right around. So what we do is basically you can purchase same mask as a Spider-Man from a party shop or any cheap shop, they do have it, or you can just print it image or draw yourself from the internet. And what you do is then you just simply or enlarge it, you can make it straight away enlarged if you like it, or you just draw yourself, as I said before. What we do is here cut out eyes as well, because we actually won't have like a real mask. What I saw I like to edit is that this dough need to be roll out as thick as 0.5 millimeter, which is 1/4 inch. Now we have a little tiny here, we can edit to make it proper headpiece for Batman. So what we do is here, of course, we need to get eyes out. Here we are. Make them slightly larger, otherwise, as I said before, dough might rise. And we'll just close up everything. So what we do is here, carefully work all your patterns. I'm not quite sure if I can transfer like that, so we might be using some spatula for transfer, hope. I think I used even 2 spatulas. Oops. Oh, sorry, Betty. My spatula fell off. Now, let's have a look. It's a hard one. Here we go. So once you're done with the Batman as well, straighten up everything to make sure it looks nicely done. But do not worry excessively if something a little bit out of place. I tell you why, because we will place it ready to roll icing or fondant on top of it as well. So we use one of popsicle sticks as well, and my kind of here we are, right in the middle. And we'll carefully insert it in. Make sure it's nicely secure. Now, next one is we do the Captain America shield. For this, we just need one round cookie cutter. And for Captain America, we just use a large cookie cutter and insert one of popsicle sticks inside. So I made it quite large ones, as you can see. And it's a kind of real size, basically. You can actually use it as a mask. You can cut out all different sorts of your favorite characters. You can actually cut out, as I said to you, from printed from the internet and make a real size of it. Or you can make it smaller if you like it. But what I'm saying is obviously smaller to easy work out with, to manage. But with bigger ones, you can make it eyes. See, you can make it cut out eyes and make it a really realistic look. So what we do is next, we place in a preheated oven at 180 Celsius, which is 350 Fahrenheit. And we bake for to about 8 to 11 minutes, roughly, depending on your oven. Once it's basically just a lightly brown from outside, just take it out, let it cool, and we will decorate it. Once our cookies are baked, as you can see, they're perfectly well. You can hold them nicely, just like your mask. And something with the Spider-Man. it holds very well, and with the Captain America shield as well. So as a nicely and great for parties. Now what we do is here we're using one box ready to roll icing. You can use fondant as well. It's whatever you're able to find it, or whatever your favorite as well. So what we do is here we're using same templates, which is we use to cut our shape of a Spider-Man mask and a Batman headpiece. So take out from a foil and roll out on and knead basically on your working surface, sprinkle with powdered icing sugar to prevent sticking. Knead until it's nice, soft and manageable. So what you do is next roll it out and we will start cutting out our shapes. So use simply same template and the use sharp knife to cut out from the ready to roll icing or from the fondant. A lot of professional bakers do use this to instead of a floor icing, but what I want to say, it's all up to you. You most definitely can use floor icing if you like to do so, and it's no problem. Just takes a little bit longer because you have to wait until it hardens before you're able to decorate. Now another thing I like to tell as well, that once your cookies are baked, and if the rise and a little bit close too much of the eye, what you do is right on a because you won't cool them down on the same baking pan, but while they're still warm, while they're still soft before they harden, take one of the sharp knife and make it a little bit basically get rid of a little bit excess, making eye a little bit more open, because they do not close, but they just become smaller sort of, which is you want to keep a shape. So simply trim away any of the extras which is being basically inside our eyes. Simply just while it's still hot, just trim it away. So here we are. We cut out. So what we do is next, we're using sugar syrup. I think probably we could use something like jam as well. Wouldn't be much different. Just a tiny bit, slightly brush. Now, what we've done is here, we cut out our Spider-Man mask. And of course, we've done it ice as well. Because I roll it a little bit early, it's tiny bit, to just want it stick to the working surface. So we actually, here we just lift it with knife. So what we do, get rid of that part, and here we are. So what we do, we place on top of our ready and cooled cookies, and you just simply just manipulate a little bit to make sure it's get a shape you really want to see. So you just fiddle around to make it right shape for your Spider-Man mask. It's very easy to do because while ready to roll icing or fondant, depend whatever you're using, is still soft and manageable. You can make it practically any shape you really want. So if it starts sticking to your hands, take a little bit of powdered icing sugar and start working. So what we do is we just wanted to make it beautiful shape of Spider-Man mask. Just shape it up your fondant or ready to roll icing, depend whatever you using or whatever you find it. As I said before, you most definitely can use floor icing. Just simply do as all principles applies. You just outline everything and then you can fill up with the floor icing. So Spider-Man is almost done. We need it decorated now. So what we do is next, we're going for the Batman and we cut out Batman and place it on top, just like we've done with Spider-Man, and using sugar syrup to stick it in. Once you've done them all, Spider-Man, Batman, and a Captain America shield. For Captain America shield, we're using different sizes of the cookie cutters. So if you, this is bigger than what we use for actually cut out shield. So next one, as you can see, we place this one to leave it one border. And anyway, for I think we'll use next one. And we basically use different cookie cutters to making design patterns of the shield of Captain America, and using a little tiny star cookie cutter to place it on the middle. Basically, that's how we created our shield. So what we do is next, obviously, to color shield, it's not difficult because we're just using red and blue liquid food coloring and follow patterns of the Captain America shield. With the Batman, we use black liquid food coloring and apply all over. That would be easy as well. If you do not find it any kind of liquid food coloring, you can easily use gel food coloring and thin it with the water or different sort of alcohol. You can use vodka, gin, or vanilla vodka, for example, flavored ones. They're even better. Difference is, if you want it thin, your gel food coloring, is if you're using alcohol, it will fast dry is faster. If you're using water based, like water or lemon essence, vanilla essence, you can do, but you do need use clear ones, clear vanilla essence, and to make sure you not disturb any color, otherwise it's mixed up and you get totally different color. What I like also to say is that alcohol mixed with gel food coloring dry much faster. With water or vanilla essence will dry much slowly. So it's your choice what you basically want to use. But if you're able to find it liquid food coloring, it's already done, so you don't have to worry about it. It just depends. For small areas, you probably will use gel food coloring straight from the little jar and apply with the toothpick. So for Spider-Man, we just simply follow patterns on our mask. As I said, you can purchase from a cheap shop. It's a plenty masks everywhere, as well as a printed from the internet. So follow patterns, and what you do is find it one of those brushes which is nice and sort of, and make everywhere patterns of Spider-Man on top of your cookie. A lot of professional cooks using coloring straight from the bottom. Actually, this is what you get while you're coloring your fondant. It's exactly something, it's exactly the same coloring. Would you apply on top or you mix it together? It makes no difference. If you have it, for example, black the fondant or black ready to roll icing, you just can apply on a Batman straight away. Alright, so let's go and color. Basically, started from a Batman. So use medium size brush and start applying. Everywhere around until you completely cover whole fondant. If you use it like that, you're actually using less coloring than in a fondant. Fondant often, especially darker colors or ready-to-roll icing, is not much sort of difference. It takes just so much of gel food coloring to tint it than with the right color. So sometimes it's much easier to use a liquid food coloring or thin your gel food coloring and apply on top of fondant or ready-to-roll icing. Let's proceed and finish. As you can see, we follow basic patterns of a Captain America shield and color them in something with the Batman. It's not quite set such as yet. So what we do with Spidey? Basically, we've done our patterns. We've done black liquid food coloring. As I said, you can use gel food liquid food coloring, gel food coloring, as well as you can actually thin it with water or alcohol. You want to dry faster, use alcohol. If you work slow, use water or clear vanilla essence. So what we do for Spider-Man, we just apply red liquid food coloring. As I said, if you apply this, it's much easier because you don't need it to cut it little tiny pieces to set them together in order of a different color fondant. Like this, you just can color as you go in colors you need it. And so what basically is it's much easier basically to do, and as well as you will definitely use much less coloring that will be in the which is tinted fondant or ready to roll icing. Once you done that, what you do is you can use black gel food coloring, take a toothpick, and we start making patterns. Just dip it in, straight in like that. And what we do, we make a pattern. One goes to right on the middle. Here. As you can see, it's very easy to do. So what you do is now you can just dip in a little bit more to making them more visible. And it's done. As you can see, we finished now. And they come out really nicely, isn't it? It's a nice cookie to eat, sort of. You can choose between a shield of Captain America, a Spider-Man, a mask, or the Batman mask. Batman tiny bit not set coloring such as yet. So I hope you do like this sort of recipe. If you like it, please do try. Everything will be in the description box. Any questions, please do write. Thank you very much for your time with me today. Until next time, goodbye.